in the movies and on television, there's a series, there was a series recently called Vegas, and about the establishment of casinos in Vegas and so forth. There's this kind of patina coming from the past about being gambling, casino gambling, being associated with crime and
One month after I opened my office as the first president of the American Gaming Association back 18 years ago, the movie Casino came out, which of course created problems for me because it brought back some of the old stories and shibboleths about the gaming industry, which were true. I mean, I grew up in Nevada. I knew the old Nevada as well as the new Nevada. That all changed with when corporate people were allowed to come in, major corporations, publicly held corporations, not only regulated toughly by the state, by the Securities and Exchange Commission, et cetera. So that is gone, but there's still there, there's a moral aspect to this.
Talk about that.
I poll every year, or I did when I was chairman of the association, and I'm sure my successor will continue. We use great pollsters. Peter Hart of the Wall Street Journal has done my polling for years, along with Frank Luntz, a Republican, so it was always a bipartisan thing. And we know for the last 15 or 20 years, and this has been a major change from what it was 30 years ago when it was just Nevada, the casino gaming, that 80 to 85% of the American public have no problem with gaming for themselves or others. There's a hardcore 15% that are opposed to all forms of gaming. And the largest majority of that is based upon their moral views or their religious views. The Methodist Church, for example, is the strongest supporter of no casino. There's all kinds of organizations around it. And for years, the head of the anti-casino movement was a minister in the Methodist Church. I have great respect for that church, and I know it's part of the tenets of their religion that gaming is a sin. But that's a small, really small element in the United States today. You have to respect their views, and they have the right to complain and do what they want to do to try to stop it. But overwhelmingly, acceptance has come about. And it's come about for a number of reasons. Number one, the industry is an industry that produces a lot of jobs. It's very labor intensive, and particularly sometimes for the people who are the hardest to employ, people who have been hard unemployed for a long, long time. We provide good jobs, good benefits, so forth. I think last year, or 2012, it was over $8.5 billion we paid in salary and benefits to our employees around the country. And that doesn't count Native American casinos, where you have a big presence here in this state. So tax revenues and so forth have changed the view of the American people.